Hi Scorpio, welcome to your weekly reading for October 16th through the 22nd. I'm going to be taking a look at the person on your mind, how you feel about them, how they feel about you, the connection between the two of you. I will be clarifying each card so energies can change as I clarify. This is general. It may not resonate for everyone. If it does, go ahead and hit that like button. If you haven't already, subscribe to my channel so you never miss an upcoming read. Now at the end of your reading, I will be pulling an oracle message from the Rose Oracle deck to give us some more insight, guidance, and clarification on your situation. So let's go ahead and jump right in. How does Scorpio feel about the person on their mind? The Emperor comes out in a 50-50 energy, the Wheel of Fortune and the Page of Cups, as well as the Devil at the bottom of the deck. And I wasn't trying to laugh. It was just the message that came out. And I'm like, really, Scorpio, that you're trying to be funny, which it was funny. But, you know, you're like, this person thinks that they're an Emperor, but they're really not, because what was gifted to me as a blessing happened to be like, you know, a child, someone who's not grown. And more so just clinging to you, and you feel like they really hold on. There's also the fact that this person is, you feel this person can be controlling at times, and then they turn around after some time where they abuse their right in some way with you. They turn around and apologize, but you just don't like the fact that this feels very toxic. Let's go ahead and get... Let's see how they feel about you. Let's do that. Go ahead and see how this person feels about Scorpio, please. So you're trying to keep boundaries in place, but over time you're wanting to like reach out to this person and talk to them because you do care about them. They're wanting to break silence with you and message you because it's too challenging not to be with you. But you still have those feelings of, you know, yeah, they think this and that, because, you know, it's just how you feel. That's fine. But the Queen of Pentacles, this person really wants to nurture the connection and make things different between the two of you. Four of Swords comes out in a 50-50 energy. So, and then the Page of Pentacles and the Strength card, you know, they're definitely learning to, learning how to get through certain challenges, of being more loving, nurturing, understanding, listening, caring, just very grounded. So let's go ahead and get the connection between the two of you. This feels like there was somebody else. We have the Queen of Wands, we have the Three of Swords, and we have the Devil, that there was somebody that got involved and it created a breakup here. And it was a very painful breakup. Not only that, you know, somebody wanted, you know, what they wanted was just very lustful than a relationship with whoever this other person was. There's a huge apology waiting to come out. So I have that Knight of Cups at the bottom of the deck. So let's go ahead and start clarifying. We're going to start with this Emperor first for you, Scorpio. You're really turned off by this person. Wanting to fix things with you, make things right. It's getting old. You feel like, you know, every time they either reject you or treat you a certain way, which makes you feel unwanted, unloved, then they want to fix things. And you're just really tired of the BS. You don't want it anymore. You're like, nope, I want to break from it. So I just told them how I felt, I want a break, I feel good. Let's go ahead and clarify the Wheel of Fortune. Oh, look at you. Feeling really good here. So the King of Wands, the Hermit, the Temperance card, and the Ten of Cups. You are definitely taking some time to look at what it is that you want to be very successful in your life and what you want to create as, you know, something that feels very balanced to you. You know, whatever your true happiness is here within a relationship or just something that brings you true happiness. Like, oh, I have my, you know, my cat, I have my car, and I have my place, and I have my job, and I'm happy, you know, things like that. But I see you just finding a really good balance, and over some time, there's some success with really spending some time alone and getting to reconnect with who you are. So this Page of Cups is clarified by the Star, the Moon, and the Three of Pentacles. You think about reaching out to this person because you do miss them, but you're not doing it. It crosses your mind. It's just something that you start focusing on. Like, I wonder what they're doing. And, you know, the Star, the Moon, the Three of Pentacles, and the Four of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. So I see you stopping yourself like, no, no, no. It's hard to let go of this person and the, you know, the relationship, I guess, that you two have. But at the same time, you're needing to have your space. So let's go ahead and clarify this Four of Swords. This person feels that every time they say something and they speak, they say things to mess stuff up, and it just makes it very awkward and silent between the two of you. And sometimes they feel like they should just keep their mouth shut. No, seriously. The Ace of Swords, the Four of Swords, and the Nine of Pentacles. They want to break the silence between the two of you. They also feel like they're, you know, there's a miscommunication, you know, a break in communication, and every time that they say something, it comes out the wrong way, and they just don't know how to be anything other than themselves. King of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck, they're like, but I do really care about you, Scorpio. So that's what maybe they keep apologizing for, and you're like, oh, then do something about it to change it. So let's go ahead and clarify that Page of Pentacles. They want to send you a message. They want to see if there's still something there between the two of you, or if you're in a relationship, if you're seeing anybody else. You know, it's a little bit, it's very tempting to this person. They want to see if there's something still between the two of you. They know that, you know, there's passion, there's love, there's lust. You know, there's all that there. So the King of Cups is at the bottom of the deck. But we do have the Four of Wands, the Seven of Cups, and the Devil that comes out. So let's go ahead and clarify the Strength card. They think about going to see you, like traveling to see you, but they wait because they feel like you might be in a relationship and you're happy, and so they don't do anything about it. Let's go ahead and get the outcome between the two of you. This chapter closes here and a new one begins for you. It's a fresh new start, new beginning, but somebody is feeling stuck and feeling bound with where to go and which path to take, and also still wanting to reach out to them. And I feel like they are stuck wanting to reach out to you while you are moving forward. Some of you are traveling even here, but it's a fresh new start, new beginning for you, and it's one that feels really good. Let's go ahead and get a couple of oracle messages for you, Scorpio. What do you want Scorpio to know about their reading? Okay, so the first one that comes out is held. Sureness of the soil unseen helps support community. Okay, and the next one is going to be the thorn, protection, boundaries, clear communication. Absolutely. And at the bottom of the deck is going to be the Rose of Venus, alignment, flow, right relationship, and harmony. And that you will find moving forward. So be clear in your communication. Make sure that your boundaries are in place. Always remember you are protected. The unseen, ask for help. You have support all around you. Your community is there to help you. And be sureness of the soil you stand on. Ground yourself is what that is saying. So this is what I have for you, Scorpio. If it resonates, go ahead and hit that like button. I will see you in your next reading coming up. Have a good rest of your day. Bye.